The U.S. continues to grapple with the novel coronavirus outbreak, with more than 150 confirmed cases in 17 states. Washington State reported almost all the fatalities. Majority of the victims there were elderly patients in a nursing facility in Kirkland. Experts said the deadly virus may have been circulating undetected for weeks. Recently, students from Seattle University received an email that a fellow student was in contact with someone who tested positive for COVID-19. And Fil-Am students there are staying vigilant.
It just kind of made me, I guess, more aware of, I guess, just how near that the virus is to us. And it's a reality that is taking place right now. And so, I mean, I'm not exactly scared, but it has raised my own awareness. And it's definitely raised my own awareness in terms of like taking care of myself and making sure that I'm clean and I'm sanitized and everything.
Usually students are out and about on this campus as if we're populated. But as it stands, there haven't been a lot of people really showing up. I'll admit, even one of my professors is considering calling in sick. Or I'm not saying they're calling in sick, but they're reporting that they're not feeling 100% and we might not even have that class on Thursday. I also noticed that some of my classmates aren't even showing up to our scheduled lectures.
The World Health Organization said that the latest global death rate for COVID-19 is 3.4%, way higher than that of the seasonal flu, which kills about 0.1% of those infected. The novel coronavirus has caused the deaths of more than 3,100 people and infected close to 93,000 worldwide. Fil-Ams in the healthcare industry are doing what they can to help prevent the spread of the virus.
Our entire organization has been really proactive about making sure that all the employees are protected and that we're still able to really take good care of all the patients, whether or not they have coronavirus or flu-like symptoms or any other disease.
They constantly remind us that about 80% of the cases are mild and that those who are most at risk are essentially the elderly.
I think, again, just because there's still a lot of things that are unknown about the virus, I think people are just worried about any like cough or any sniffle or fevers here and there. And rightfully so, just because it is, again, a virus that's easily transmitted.
Experts said people who are at a greater risk of getting infected are those 60 and older, those with underlying health conditions, including heart disease, lung disease, or diabetes, and those with a weak immune system. Pregnant women are more vulnerable as well. Lelaine Ignau, ABS-CBN News, Seattle, Washington.
Mm.